Hello folks, well as you can see I've stripped down the little one as well. They're both hanging there and I've been having a look at things. I did begin to do a little bit of the scabs on the large frame here. You can see they've basically gone down to the black undercoat, the bonderizing. So I started blocking those down, just block sanding them, and I have to admit I did sort of get carried a little bit away. There's some on the top tube here, and a couple of little bits on the down tube as well that I just had a bit of a sand at. On the little frame you can see it was painted quite roughly an orange house paint, which I've sanded most of that back off, and then I just sanded to there. Now that's an interesting point. I'm going to tell you about something now. I've discovered the secret of why these Elizabethans fade to orange, whereas the other carmine red bikes don't. For a better understanding, here's the chain case. Now, it's always been the case that other carmine red bikes just fade to either a darker or just a red, more often darker because they're sprayed over the bonderizing black coat. So like this mudguard here, it fades down to a darker, you can see particles through. Now the Elizabethan, it's always been a slightly brighter, sunnier looking red, and then with age it's faded to this orange colour, which you can see here, a distinct orange. Let me turn this light off and that might give you a better idea. No, it didn't, so never mind. Anyway, I discovered what they did. Inside here, can you see in there? It's gold. So over the original black bonderizing, which you can see around that hole there, they've sprayed gold and then they've sprayed the red. So like when you leave an old picture out in the sunshine, there you see the orange there, see that colour catching that orange. When you leave a picture out in the sunshine, you know, all the red leaches out, doesn't it? Here's the back where it hasn't had so much UV and it's redder, and then just some slightly orangier bits. And I can see it better than you can probably see it, to be perfectly honest. You can see the two frames, that one's got slightly more orange and this slightly more red. So they've sprayed gold over the black, and then they've sprayed the red, which is translucent, over the top of the gold, and that's what's given it this kind of red that catches the sun and has a bit of a glow. I could have imagined them calling it sun glow red or something like that. Anyway, that is very, very useful information for me as I'm doing the renovation, because I can now replicate that. And that is exactly what I've done on the forks. I've given the fork a nice coat of gold, ready to spray the red over the top of it. So hopefully that'll give it that similar finish. So I'm going to do that first as my test piece, see how much red it needs over the top of it, in order to come out like this. And the red is so transparent that I have been able to do a little bit of cheating on the frame. I've just had a little bit of an experiment and it seems to work. That where the paint is in decent condition but it's faded very much, I've just, you can't see it, but I've actually put a couple of light just dusting coats of the red on there, and it's brought out the red glow again but not compromised the finish. Now in this area, and other areas like this, I am going to have to spray it with red oxide primer, then a squirt of gold, and then the red. And that's how I'm going to proceed. Little areas like this, where it's just little chips, I'm going to have to get gold pen or a fine brush with gold on and touch all these in gold, all these little areas. Here is a great example you can see. Can you see that gold ring? So there's the black, there's a gold ring, and then there's the red. So you've got the three coats, the three colours demonstrated there, the black, the gold and the red. So that was a really good piece of information, and I'm going to capitalise on that now as I go through doing all the tinware. Right, so with a little light on the subject, let's start playing about with this. If spraying over the gold doesn't make it deep enough, I have some burnt orange, which is in fact this colour. So that might make a good base coat as well, if this turns out to be a bit insipid. But it will take quite a few coats. Yeah, I know I've missed the fork crown. That doesn't matter, that's going black. The crown and then the dart down each side will be black. But I'll spray the red first. We don't bother about a bit of overspray here at the Velocipedium. That's a bit of a heavy coat for a starter coat, that one. That's my main failing with spraying, is I tend to be too heavy-handed with the early coats. Wanting to see early results, you should just put that on for a first coat, but then I tend to kind of do that. And I know what I'm doing wrong, and I'm still doing it. Einstein's definition of stupidity, wasn't it? Continuing to do the same thing and expecting different results. Six coats now, and that is looking like an Elizabethan. Look at that. This is just freshly on. It's not cured or anything. I may do a little bit more down there, I don't know. But look at that. That's the key. That is the key. Starting with gold is the key. There we are. That's brilliant. The way that's turned out is just like magic. And it really confirms my conclusion of the other night, which was the gold base coat is what makes it this colour and not the usual deep carmine red with the same paint. Right, there's some interesting goings on. The gold that I was using ran out as soon as I started using it on this frame. I had another gold which was too light, as you can see, it's the pale gold from the Bob Jackson. But one coat of the burnt orange here, this colour, one coat of that on top of the pale gold makes a kind of an orangey gold, as you can see on the mudguard over there as well. So that's what I've gone for. And the mudguards down here have got... That doesn't belong there, that was sitting up there, you idiot. Yeah, that mudguard's bottom part is getting covered up anyway. But yeah, I've got the various bits on the frames orangey now, metallic orangey gold. So that's going to be fine with a few cuts of the red on top. My only worry now is that I'll run out of the red as well. Right, I have been busy. As you can see, this is the small frame, the one that was nicest anyway, where I've sprayed on to the orange gloss paint, household paint. It's gone fisheye, so I need to redo that. That was annoying. The black, I might just try a black tea cut on that to bring it up actually, rather than just get into respraying everything and doing the head badge and everything. It's a nice original bike. I'd like to keep it as original as possible. So I did down on here, where it was, well, there'd been no paint on it, and then it had a splat of household orange. and there are a couple of little bits on here, there and there, and that's it really on that frame. This frame has been slightly more extensively touched up, still a little bit more to go on yet. I'm getting woefully short of the red, which is annoying because I've still got the chain guard to do. This is the chain guard for the little one, the Raleigh speed wing from the same period. As you can see, the red oxide primer is just drying because I forgot about it. And I've got really little red paint left. This is going to be red and black. The idea is that this will be the red, and then this bit down here from this line downwards will be black, and the inside black. So I've just got this part to do in red. I'm wondering whether to do the top in black and just do this little fluted section in red to save red paint, but you know, why spoil just for a little thing like that. So back to this frame. You can see now this is all red now where it was black before, and there was a lot of paint off around here. Up the chain stays. They're not immaculate, but this isn't an immaculate bike, it's an original bike. So yeah, there are some bits like this, but there are some other bits that were worse that were actually repaired. But there's still quite a lot of, you know, I could have gone to town and taken all that back. Then I would have ended up doing a complete respray. And that's not what I was aiming for. So, oh, there's a little bit there. There's a big scab there. And you can see that it needs another little coat of red on there. But the chain stays are red now. And this area down here is red now, around the bottom bracket. That was the worst. Mudguards are still looking crap because the bottom part of this one is being covered up by mud flap anyway, but they are going to get a new black stripe. So each mudguard is getting a black stripe, so you're actually seeing them half done there. Moving to the I think there was just a couple of little bits on the rear mudguard there, and the scabby rear mudguard has, from the masking you can see, it's had a bit more paint done on it as well. But again, I've not done full restoration on it. That's not what this is. That clamp I will swap for a shiny one. There were just lots of scabs all over it. So again, it's getting a black stripe down it. That's one more mudguard left. Oh yeah, there we are. That one was pretty decent to start with. It's just had a bit of a zhizh in a couple of places, and again we'll get a black stripe. The forks now, let me put a light on, there we are. Forks are looking very nice indeed. I'm ready to get the masking on for the black crown and the black darts down the side. Black on this frame, do it a couple of little bits. There's a couple of darts there. I was thinking of masking them off and redoing them, but actually I'm not sure it needs it. Maybe I was thinking of the Boulevard Tourist, which does actually need it on its white ones. Let me turn this around. That one's a bit scabby. I can maybe mask that one off and just give it a blow in, or I could touch it up. I could get a brush on it and touch it up. It's another alternative. This is not a restoration. I should have a sign hanging on the wall. This is not a restoration. Back of the chain case had a little bit. You can see there where it's redder. That's a little bit that I did on the back of the chain case. I had this out for some reason, but really it doesn't need anything. That's fine. And it's got all its little extra pieces in. Let's have a look at the pie plate. You see the pie plate's black and it's got a very nice distinct gold line around it. So if I do anything to that, I'm going to have to mask that gold line off, which is going to be a pain. But the edge of here, again, I can just get a brush. I can run a brush or a little foam rubber along there with black paint on. And then there's these little touch-ups here as well. And because it's black, I'll give it a clear coat. and ditto the D piece that goes in there. And that'll look fine, that'll be perfectly good for the bike. So this is just an example mudguard. Just a light dust in, nothing more than a light dust. The gloss black is in quite a heavy spray aerosol, so it really blasts it on. So it's just so very carefully. And that's all it needs for the centre stripe. I have forks masked up. I'm actually doing this handheld, really. I've just put them in the vise for a moment, just so that you can see a little bit of it. And then I'll be holding the steerer in my hand and moving it round to spray it. So we've got the V's in here now. You can see how it's going to go. Inside of the blades are masked up to the crown. Underneath the crown will be black. All the crown will be black. And then the V's. And of course that chrome embellishment, like this one, is going on the fork. Right. See what I mean about this black being a bit fierce. And see what I mean about me having a bad habit of putting over thick first coats on. Right, I'm going to take this out of the vise now and twirl it around by hand. Leave that to dry now. Don't be tempted to take it off too soon, because that's when you get the raggedy edges on the masking. And the other side, not that you can really see the masking of the V now. Right, I've unmasked one leg. Now the moment of truth. When unmasking, when you reach the part that's next to the paint, don't just pull it off like that. Try and put it back down on itself like this. It just helps to stop the paint dragging. There we are. Swap hands. That point is quite crucial. But not that crucial, because it's getting a gold line. There we are, dart one. Right, so one step back. I was an idiot, wasn't I? So eager was I to show you that lovely moment of truth scene where you pull the masking off and everything's wonderful. I forgot that there's a gold line going around the edge, so I've had to remask it. Well, I definitely wouldn't get a job at Raleigh doing pinstriping, although they used a wheel tool, of course. But it's okay. It's kind of like they had originally. On this part here, there's a little bit of there down underneath, a little bit here where this clamp was across, where there's some original lining. Let me put the light on for you. See where it's out of step? That's actually original lining, that little bit there, right in the middle. So it was that thick. Alright, that is the frame lined. Now, I know that looks thick, but it's the correct thickness. I know it looks a bit garish, probably something how it looked new, but I am going to knock it back a bit. I think once it's all dry, I think I'm just going to buff back a little bit and take some of it off, so it'll look like, you know, it's lining that's a little bit worn, rather than lining that some incompetent clown has just put on with a marker pen. As I said, I can always knock the gold back a little bit if it's too garish for me, but it is how it looked when it was new. As for little Lizzie, there is little Lizzie, looking very nice indeed. Chain guard black inside, nothing much to see here really. There's the fluted section at the bottom with some black on it as well. I'll give that another coat. And let's not forget yon forks. That's the first and the worst of the mudguards, meaning it was in the worst condition. As you can see, I've not done a full resto on it, just left some of the original scars, but repainted the black stripe down the middle. That's not a wobbly black stripe, that is just a bit of, that's just a bit of old scabbage as well next to it. That's looking quite tacky wet because it's got fresh clear coat on it. A clear coat of course is controversial because many people say we shouldn't really clear coat because it makes it look too shiny. Yeah, but you don't have to have it looking shiny. If I want this mudguard to look like this mudguard, all I have to do is go over it afterwards with T-cut or 1500 wet and dry, but T-cut would be better, and then it'll just knock the plasticky look off it. It'll still look quite shiny, nice shiny, showroom shiny, rather than wet shiny. But you still get your protection, and that's the big thing with clear coat, is getting protection. So on that note, I'm going to make my escape now, and I'll put this video together. That's your painting stage. Oh, did you see the red chain guard hanging up there as well? There it is, look. That's yon painting stage. Next is assembly. I'm going to give this a couple of days to harden off so I don't put fingerprints on it. Might give it all a T-cut before I put it back together. In the meantime, of course, I'll do the other three mudguards. That was just a tedious job of masking, to the extent that I've run out of masking tape. Okay, thanks for watching. See you next time for the reassembly.